Remember, all hypnosis is self-hypnosis. Please do not listen to this recording while driving or doing any dangerous activity involving tools or otherwise. This journey is a special journey and a true journey. It takes us back 30, 50, perhaps 100,000 years ago to the time of what has been called our primitive ancestors, our past. They may have been the same as us in form, but it is true that some things they had to learn for the first time. We will go back to a time when you, your genetic line, your soul, gained a gift for the first time, something that is still with you, that you can still use, something that was important to your people, to your tribe, to your clan. But first, let us relax. Let us get comfortable. Ground ourselves in the here and the now. Feel our bodies softening, loosening. It's okay to feel good. It's okay to clear your mind. Relax. Be comfortable. Relax. 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 Let your power chakras, your sexual chakras, your survival chakras, relax. Let their guard down. It's okay to be vulnerable and soft and comfortable in the safe and sacred space that you and we are creating. Feel that energy connect and drift down into the earth like a cord of energy, gaining sustenance from the inner lower worlds of the earth, nurturing you like an umbilical cord, giving you love, giving you confidence, letting you relax further. Let us do a countdown from five and then move to the heart chakra. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We are there, the heart chakra, known as green in color, the most powerful and useful and needed and primary chakra to allow the others to work fully, naturally, and comfortably. Expand your heart chakra. Feel your heart chakra. If you are soft and vulnerable and comfortable, it should be okay in this sacred space to connect with your heart chakra. It is safe. It is pleasant. It is beneficial. Open your heart. 3, 2, 1. We are at the lower throat chakra. This too is relaxed. This is calm. This is the place of understanding and communication. You will need this chakra to be active and open as you receive the knowings, the words, the knowledge, the blessings, the images, the pictures, whatever comes to you from that time long ago, 30,000, 50,000, 100,000 years ago, our ancestors, your ancestors, your clan, your soul, the part of you that wants to retrieve this great gift. 3, 2, 1. We are at the third of the upper chakras, the pineal gland, the third eye, the mind's inner door, the mind's eye, the chakra that allows being, vision, visualization, intuition, knowing, expansion. The pineal gland on birth and death releases incredible imaginative powers to ease us through transitions, as too it will now. 3, 2, 1, relax. Release powers of the imagination to take us 30, 50, 100,000 years before you see the fire of your clan burning. It is nighttime. 3, 2, 1, relax. Your crown chakra as well is open. You know yourself in this time, tens of thousands of years ago. You know who you are. You are someone different, slightly on the margins. Not abused, not hurt, but unknown. You have no specific role, no importance, no distinguishment yet. And this night is a special night. The fire is raging, the stars are shining. The chiefs, the warriors, the priests, the dancers, the chanters, the drummers are all participating, but it's a ceremony that has meaning, but perhaps not another quality, one that you're aware of, a special quality, a gifted quality, a quality of higher consciousness, of awareness. 3, 2, 1. So relaxed, so back in time, so near that hot, burning, blazing fire your people, your clan, so rely upon. That fire that has always been there. 3, 2, 1. Since the lightning struck, since it burns and is fed by the people with twigs and leaves and sticks, that fire that sits there and has sat there for many times and days and weeks and been used and grown the memory of your tribe, your clan. 3, 2, 1. So, so relaxed. So in the past. So with your primitive peoples, your power peoples, your energy, your genetic line. On this strange and unusual night, this night you are sitting alone, playing with symbols and rocks and twigs, creating a design. You're feeling good. And on this night walks by you an elder, one, a shaman, a warrior, a hunter, a special person who first ushered in some of the new knowledge. He notices your symbol, and he enjoys it. He likes it. Beyond that, he knows it is special. He taps you on the shoulder and tells you to come with him. He is going off into the night. He is one of the few, the only, that has the skills to walk at night away from the tribe, away from the fire. He takes you. You don't know why. A couple people see you go. It's okay. This man has authority. He has knowledge. He is respected within the tribe. And he takes you into the darkness and has you hold on to his makeshift belt of leather. As you wander deeper into the darkness, you trust his guidance. You trust his movements. He is sure-footed. He knows paths. He knows what he is looking for. He has a rock. He has a spear. You follow him. Your breath is held, but excited. You are on a hunt. You have been chosen to learn or see something new. And your mind is opening to who you are. You are thinking of yourself as special. You are gifted, and you have been chosen, and you are learning. You are doing what one of the few can do. Walking in the night away from the tribe, the fire. You are hunting, you are gathering, you are seeing, you are scouting, you are protecting. You are important. And this great elder, this warrior, this shaman, this hunter, goes to a quarry, senses his prey, throws his rock, then his spear, and sure enough, he has got an animal. something to bring back, a prize to eat, to use its skin, its teeth, its bones. Everything is used by your clan. This is vital. You must know the night as well as the day. It is important to be one of the few who know how to do this. Anything can come out of the night. And now you are special since you know the night. You protect, you see, you gather, you hunt. As you make your way back to the tribe, more thoughts and feelings and inspirations and intuitions of who you are and what you can do come to you. You are young. As you walk back with the gift of this prize, this food, this animal, this equipment, these objects, these tools you can gather from this animal, the tribe now further acknowledges you. You are with the shaman, the hunter. You have been chosen by the elder, the warrior. You have completed a night mission. Few have done this. Few are able. Few understand, but you understand. As you walk forward, a greater thought occurs to you. Something huge, something magical, something powerful, something innovative, a technology, an evolution, something even the great shaman warrior has not thought of. You walk confidently to the fire. You bend down and reach into it with your hand and grab a stick. At the edge of the stick is a flame. The fire goes with the stick. It is carried, and you pronounce your sacred words. As you move toward the darkness, others realize what you are doing. The fire can be moved, not just where the lightning struck it. The fire has power to move. It can be taken with you. Others pick up sticks and follow you. A group now can go into the darkness, into the night by itself. This is power. This is change. This is your original creation. You have sparked a new consciousness. You are from a kin soul genetic line that knows how to build, to create, to advance. Your people can move at night as a group. They can hunt, protect, scout, fight, build, defend. This is truly incredible. In the morning, you wake up and sit up. After the night's celebration, after the magnificent foraging, exploring, and hunting, after the tribe of many gathered what was needed and learned and saw and scouted the surrounding areas at night and took home things and hunted and brought animals with tools and food, you sit up in the morning after the celebration and you notice five of the elders standing around you. One is the chief. He has something in his hands for you. Only a few get this object. There is only one of these objects that get passed down from person to person. In this time, not even the shaman warrior got this object. It is a necklace with 12 saber-toothed tiger teeth. It is sacred. It took many, many, many years and generations of hunters. And many have died fighting the saber tooth. Only a few have come back with teeth, with skin, with meat of the saber tooth. And now it is you, because of your gift, your creation, your technology, who shall wear this sacred amulet, this necklace of saber tooth, tiger teeth. Indeed, you are acknowledged for your specialness and for your gift by the clan. Now, with feelings of invigorated confidence and resounding new resiliency, you come back to your present state with the knowledge and power of what you can create and what you have created, what your soul and you and your genetic line have done in the past. You are a seeker. You are an inventor. You are a seer. You were then, and you are now. You shall now use this ability as you see fit to help your current clan. You shall redefine your clan, make your clan larger if you choose, because you will find acceptance. You have a gift, and you wear the amulet of saber-tooth tiger teeth. 3, 2, 1. Wake up. You are a new you. You're feeling good. You're feeling refreshed. You're ready to create something. You're ready to be something. You are something. Enjoy.